Are you? Sorry, I actually have the most fun playing with the camera before I even put it down. I have the most fun playing with the camera. It's like a game of peekaboo because you're always obstructing the lens and then you're like, oh, look at that, oh, look at that. You basically, it's like, dude, a video is like a fucking, it's like a picture frame and you just move it around and whatever. It's kind of amazing in a way. It's like a painting that you can, I'll stop. I think about the possibilities of video. Me and my dad used to watch that Windows Media Player Visualizer where it's just like auras and lights and...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, just like when you listen to music on a computer in the 90s, you could go to Windows Media Player and it would you could click on this thing called Visualizer and it would just do different shit. It was cool. Sounds really watered down, but then he gets kind of gritty with it. I'm like,
yeah,
okay.
Like,
it sounds like he's like, you know, like I said, it gets better, but at the beginning, it sounds like disturbed.
The only
like
song
disturbed.
He has that is good, I think. I mean, I listened to one before, it was alright, but.
But it was funny because one time you skipped Sound of Silence by Disturbed because it had an intro like that, and you were like, oh fuck no. And I was like, if only you knew this is like the same band as this motherfucker. Sometimes you just have to wait through the shitty part to go to it. You're like basically we traded places up in this bitch. Man. I trained her so well. I'm like you, I only have a few, probably like fucking 10 to 15 songs I actually listen to religiously. I would crawl away with you. I guess they just both call each other Thriller, so eventually I was like, that, those two are just Thriller. I'd be like, you know? I mean, like, that's how it went. And, dang, what was I going to try? Something about Charles. Oh, yeah, Kenneth got him out there, and he was trying, he was like, kind of doing like, he's kind of, everyone's kind of a stand up comedian, exhibitionist, whatever. He was in it, he was feeling himself, so he stood up there, and he was giving this little, like, monologue about how that kid came up to him. Or, well, before the kid he shot, I think they had a few words. Or I'm not even sure who the fuck he was shit-talking, honestly. I don't think that... whatever. He was just giving a performance talking about, I called that kid everything under the sun except a child of God. He said, you know, you don't hit me in the mouth. I'm 62 years old. Hit me in the mouth. And he said, I had my fucking gun back here.
And
I was ready. And the kid didn't hit him. And he said, if you don't hit me in the mouth... He's like, I haven't been hitting the mouth in a long time. Like, if you don't do it, little boy, you're a whore. Like, all this shit, like... It's kind of funny. Because a lot of people trying to talk shit, like, oh, you don't want this old man. And he's like, motherfucker, I do want him, motherfucker. Hit me, motherfucker. And just left him alone.
Oh.
He's stout. I mean, he's built like me. I think he would fucking probably win a fight against me, honestly, just because he's old.
I was kind of jealous when you said Linda was with you.
If that was the last woman on earth, I'd just shove her off a cliff. Fuck that bitch. Seriously.
I'll probably get done more work than her. Did she do any work?
Okay, the reason she was there is because she's Ken's girlfriend and she knows what he likes.
Yeah.
Kind of like your little piss poor, whatever the fuck you call him, Chris guy.
Yeah.
Should know what the fuck to put in the fucking box that's in.
Exactly.
Instead of being all up your ass like a doggy. Hey, will you want me any favorites? Ooh. It's so fucking weird. You show me pictures and he looks like a hardened man. And then he acts like a little fucking kid. He's like, yeah, chasing your skirt. And hey. I'm like, dude, I don't have respect for you. What the fuck, dude? Like, men are such they just look hard, but they're so fucking stupid a lot of the time.
But I was kind of happy.
Chris, you look hard, but you act like a fucking child. Hey!
I'm glad.
She's fucking gone, dog! I don't even fucking explain that to you, dude.
And I love you, baby.
I feel sorry for the motherfucker because he's going to spend his life thinking that you're not. She's not. I don't know. I guess some people want to live like that. It's fine. I don't know. I don't get it, but I'm going to do it.
I was saying, like, this pretty chick bouncing her butt up and down.
Oh, my God. No.
Yeah,
no, she was sitting her ass down because she's woozy from some stupid fucking med she's on because she's a fat, worthless sack of shit in her whole life. And she can't fucking remember 1 minute from the next. She lost her wallet at one point and thought we'd stole it.
Oh, shit.
He was like, no, my shit was in this Walmart bag, and then it looked like somebody busted it open. Somebody must have ripped it open. And she wasn't saying one of you guys did it, but the way she was explaining it, and then she got her Kenneth on the phone. But fortunately, that guy Charles went in the next room. Was like, it's right on the fucking table. Stupid cunt.
Yeah.
All she did was get in the way. Can't be a sassy bitch. She does not have a pretty face, but there's nothing on her that's pretty. I mean, nothing.
I don't think nothing.
Not the voice, nothing. I mean, just,
I love you, baby.
We do. I don't know how Kenneth puts up with that shit. What the fuck? It's a joke too. You're kind of the right fret for one.
You can do this.
Oh, no, you're good. No, I'm just saying it's funny. I couldn't even mimic what he was doing. It sounded like something I would do. I couldn't do it. I was like, what?
I even asked David Geff in person if he'd buy it for me.
Especially, I was trying to play something ugly and I couldn't. I was like, well, bro, what? Everything I do on guitar is too pretty. Soup on the If you don't hear me, just let it go, basically. Go ahead and stop me and ask me what. Just ignore me. Because you're interfering with me just thinking, basically. Ozzy Osbourne looks like something I would eat when I was high. Just he's just kind of fatty, just kind of like. Sorry. He looks like a little marshmallow motherfucker you could just eat. Ozzy Osbourne. I said he looks like something I would eat when I'm high, because he just kind of. He looks like a little penguin, like a little fucking marshmallow penguin.
I don't know how he got.
Saying. He doesn't have any hair on his face. He looks like a little marshmallow penguin. Sorry. Dude, most. I can't even make fun of people without beards because I only had this for a year. But I mean, everyone looks like a little chump. At least you're a woman. You don't need that. But I feel like a man needs it. I don't know. It brings me comfort. Because otherwise, I look like a chump.
I like your beard. I don't want you to shame me.
I can't go back.
Leave your mustache. Shave.
Don't me want to hear you growl.
You don't let me now. Yeah, you're my little guard dog, ain't you, baby? Yeah.
I want you to go.
Yeah. You ain't gonna mess with me. We're talking about his beard now. All right, I'm gonna shave your beard too. What if you shave?
I'm not barking at you, Stormy.
I had a brain fart. Alright. From here down, shave your beard and just leave your mustache and the beard here.
Oh, yeah, like a goatee.
Yeah.
No chops. Just say no chops. Hold it. Get rid of your chops.
That would look good. And I wonder what your grandma would
do. I feel like when I really look at like the shape of the beard, it makes me feel like the front thing of a train, like a fucking steam engine has got this thing where it kind of goes like, argh. It's like a grill, you know what I'm saying? It's like, I like it. At first I thought it was too weird, but it's like, at a certain point, it's like, it's the reason that I love the beard. It's like my security blanket. I'm so uncomfortable all the time with trying to figure people out and figure the world out. It's my little blanket. Without it, it's even worse. It's
feel
like no protection at all.
Did I make you have the beard?
That's how people end up killing people and shit. Like they had to shave their beard for their job. Like, man, I look like a little bitch, too. I am a little bitch. I'm gonna fucking kill someone.
I know, but did I make you grow a beard?
No, it was just for fun. People kept telling me I should. Every time I would start a new job, they'd be like, oh, you look like a little fucking 5-year-old. Well, they'd say 20-year-old, and I was 30, so I was like, all right. I grew the, and I'd see a lot of other guys with longer hair than me and bigger, much bigger beards, like Santa beard. They're like, all right, I mean, you can get away with anything here at Tom Drexler. So I tried it there. And then at West Shore Home, I always shave when I get a new job. It's out of respect to the person interviewing me. That's how I was raised. I don't know. You kind of like, those, in some way, facial hair and just different things like that, I would call privileges. They're out of the normal. But, and you should kind of like have to earn those types of things. If the world was like the military, not everything's like the military.
Oh my God, I'd never be able to get in the military.
Let you have a beard. Head. I know they have to keep your head. I bet they
you
don't have a beard.
You have to shave your head sometimes.
Yeah, it can only be like up to like half an inch or something. Like you can't.
My hair.
I get it. It's so for your combat ready. No one can grab you from the head and slit your throat or something.
Yeah,
I mean,
well, my hair used to be nice. I mean, it used to be about right down to here, but I fucked it up with fucking collar.
I don't really understand how soldiers are expected to just be over there in constant threat without some kind of fucking drugs. And a lot of them don't. I mean, can you just imagine? You get used to it. That makes you like a hard man.
Yeah.
You're like, well, it's like, well, man, it's just happening, man. I'm going to bed, man. Everything's fucked up here, man. I'm feeling bad, man. I guess that's kind of how they look at it. Man, maybe next week I'll just kick in some bitch's door and like shoot her kids and just like rape her and kill her. Oh, yeah. That's what they, people.
Yeah,
that's
they do. I mean,
that's centuries old. That's just what men at war do. They kick in door because it's like it's almost like a fucking fantasy. Why not? They don't have to fucking die. Fuck you, motherfucker.
Why can't women just go in there and kick doors down?
I would feel wrong about raping someone. I can understand it.
It's
almost out of anger, but if you don't, if there's no, I don't know.
I mean,
I would have to be really, and that's wrong too, because I mean, it's just the person. I'm gonna just say I'm not okay with busting in someone's house and breaking a person, just because of the terror that inspires them. I mean,
it's fucked up. I mean, sick. It's kind of sick. I mean,
just go to a fucking whorehouse, basically. You know.
But I might rape you. I'm fucking with you,
baby.
I'm just like...
I like to see you fucking
drive. Love me, baby. Alright, so step off.
First fucking DJ I met in my life.
I know.
Your song choices are perfect, but then you just keep. Oh, you like this? Okay.
You're
gonna like. Yeah, you can stroke my little ego.
I'm so
big
right now.
You're gonna like this one.
I just had to spit, that's all. You should finish the song, yeah. The second half's that. Oh my god. Fuck you, Lisa, what are you doing?
I don't know.
Can you just let songs fit? If there's only a minute left, I mean...
I'm not a good DJ, but...
You're fucking dumb. I'm gonna call it like it is.